Hey folks, this is Kevin Knebel in beautiful Monument, Colorado at 7,500 feet of elevation, coming to you today on behalf of the Schweike Media Business Booster webinar series. And today we're going to be talking about how to optimize your Twitter profile, how to make sure your Twitter profile looks good, and really basically set up your Twitter account. Now, we have other webinars where we get into lots of other nuances of how to use Twitter, but today is really about how to set up a Twitter account most effectively. So Twitter is what I refer to as global text messaging. It's basically text messaging all around the world, either to one individual or to large groups of individuals. So you go to twitter.com, and the good thing about Twitter is it's probably the easiest of the social media platforms to wrap your head around. It's pretty simple. I've been very fortunate that I've helped individuals and organizations generate literally millions of dollars using Twitter as a business building tool. A lot of people think Twitter, isn't that Kim Kardashian and SpongeBob? And, you know, it is Kim Kardashian and SpongeBob, but, sorry, I had to take a sip of my water there, but so is a telephone. You know, if you waste your time on the telephone talking about SpongeBob and Kim Kardashian, don't get mad at the phone. Just stop doing that. It's the same thing with social media. So with Twitter, you could waste a lot of time doing Kim Kardashian and SpongeBob, or you can generate a lot of business and make a lot of money and have a lot of fun. So Twitter's a great platform. What you're looking at right now is you're looking at my Twitter account. So when you go to twitter.com and you set up a Twitter account, the first thing you do is you put your name in. So my name is Kevin Knebel. Could I please buy another vowel? And then you create a handle. If you're like me, if you're an old fart, you've been around since the earth was cooling, you remember back in the 70s there was CB radios, and they used to have this thing called handles. And those were crazy names that people would invent for themselves when they got on CB radio. Well, there's handles in the Twitter world too. So everything in the Twitter world, your name comes after the at or ampersand sign. And then my handle is at Kevin Knebel. So you can do that by your name or your company's name, however you want to do that. So my real name is Kevin Knebel, and then I've got at Kevin Knebel as my handle. Then you create a picture. I have a funny picture of me reading my book. It's kind of a branding tool for me. And now Twitter allows you to have a very large back picture. It didn't used to offer this, now it does. This is kind of a fuzzy picture. I need to get a better picture, but for right now it works. But this is me speaking in front of an audience of about 2,000 people at a speaking engagement. So this is me. Then you've got your bio. Here's your entire bio. It's only 120 characters. Now, unlike LinkedIn and Facebook, which can be a little bit more Rubik's Cubish and a little bit longer and a little more verbose, a LinkedIn summary offers 2,000 characters. A LinkedIn bio only offers 120. I would suggest you use all of the available space, because it's almost like dating. Now, it's been many, many years since I was dating, but you're trying to grab somebody's attention. You're just trying to grab their attention. So instead of just putting your job title, put something that might catch somebody's attention here. And you could always put, you can always go back and change it later on. So I've got my title, Social Selling and Relationship Marketing, International Speaker, Author, Trainer, Coach. Then I have a little star that I just took off of Microsoft Office as a spacer. And then I've got my tagline. And then a little smiley face for me over the years has become a little bit of a branding tool also. So that's it. That's my bio. Underneath here is where you put the city that you live in. Now, I use a lot of humor in my presentation, so I actually don't have Monument, Colorado, which is the town I live in. I have airplanes and hotels because I travel a lot. Just in the last 30 days, I've delivered presentations in Pennsylvania, Colorado, New Jersey, Sydney, Australia, and London, England. So I get around a little bit. So for me, I'm on the road a lot. So just for fun, I put in airplanes and hotels. You have a link to one website. This is my website. And if you don't have your own website, I would suggest the link goes to your LinkedIn profile, because your LinkedIn profile is really your electronic digital business card. So if you are an employee or for whatever reason you don't have your own website, I would suggest this link go to your LinkedIn profile. And if you don't have a LinkedIn profile, watch one of the other Schweike Media webinars. I've done a ton of them for Schweike on optimizing LinkedIn. And then here it shows when you joined Twitter. So that's it. That's the entire thing in terms of setting up your picture, your background picture, your bio, the city you live in, the website. That's it. Then what you want to do is you want to actually populate your Twitter account. So if I go here to where it says who to follow, oops, let me do it a different way. If I go to find friends, I can actually merge my email accounts. So instead of me going onto Twitter and going into the search box and typing in somebody's name and possibly taking a long time to identify the right person, if I use Gmail or Outlook or one of these platforms, I can just click on the button and it will actually reconcile. Twitter will reconcile all of the email addresses in your Outlook account against the over 300 million people on Twitter worldwide to identify who on Twitter has an email address associated with their account that matches the one in your Outlook account. Well, this is a huge time saver, absolutely huge. So that's going to save you a tremendous amount of time. I would strongly encourage you to go this route because it's just a much more time-effective way to populate your Twitter account with people that you already know or have been in communication with by email. I can also click on who to follow. Now, if I want to type somebody's name in here, I can type anybody's name in there and it will search all of Twitter. I'm going to type Steve's name in here. Steve's the guy who that actually records these videos. And if I type Steve Einar, there he is. Look at that handsome devil. That's the guy right there. And I can follow Steve. So now I'm following Steve. We'll get back to what following means in a couple minutes. So here you can actually use Twitter, and you can even get into advanced search features, how to find people with all kinds of different ways. It can get pretty advanced, and I don't mean to confuse you with this. So here, if I go to who to follow, I can follow somebody by typing their name in, and also Twitter is making some suggestions based on the algorithms based on who I'm already following. So that's interesting to look at, too, who they're suggesting I should follow. And I can also look at popular accounts. So if you like sports and you say, I wonder who they're suggesting for sports, well, you've got Kevin Durant, and these are all pretty much famous people. The little check in the blue box means this is a verified account. This really is LeBron James. It's not somebody trying to play LeBron James or a parody account. It's the real deal. So I could say, oh, I want to follow Shaq, or I want to follow Major League Baseball. And you can see that I'm actually following some of these people already. If I wanted to follow means you're going to see what they post in your news feed. If I wanted to follow the NHL, I would just hit follow, and then there it does. So that's how we can find who to follow, and a high-level suggestion that I would give you would be in a more and more interconnected, over-caffeinated, hyper-competitive Mach 5 with your receding hairline on fire, crackberry, blackberry world, you can't be connected to too many people. Because you never know where your next lead, prospect, client, networking partner, strategic alliance, spouse, whatever. I'm just seeing if you're listening. So you know, you never know. So let's get connected to a lot of people and let's add as much value to people as we possibly can, because without trying to sound too much like a motivational speaker, I have a lot of evidence that proves that the more value we add to people over time, the easier it is to lead a successful life on all kinds of different levels, way beyond just money. Money's easy. You can always make more money. Just figure out how to add more value. Seminar over. Okay, so that's how you add your connections. Then when you start to connect with people, you can actually add them to lists. Twitter. Because the more people you're following, the harder it's going to be to keep track of all this, because it's going to be like drinking from a fire hydrant. So right now you're looking at my account, and you can see that I'm following 10,199 people. That's a lot of people. I've got 10,225 people following me. Well, if I opened up Twitter and I tried to make sense of all this stuff that's coming in at Mach 5, I'm never going to find the needle in the haystack, because some of the things that are posted are as stupid as what somebody had for lunch, but some of the other things that are posted will make you a lot of money if you know how to create business. So it's always about looking for the needle in the haystack. So what Twitter allows you to do is it allows you to create lists. So if I create lists, now I can create lists based on whatever it is I want to create the list on. And I can make them public or I can make them private. So when I accept somebody's invitation, or let me say it a different way, when I follow somebody, I put them into a list where appropriate. So I'll give you an example. I have simple daily standard operating procedures across all social media platforms, things I do every single morning. So here I open up followers. And these are the newest people that have decided to follow me on Twitter in chronological order. So in the upper left-hand corner, this Amy Marshall person, who I don't know, she is the newest person to follow me. This guy is the second most recent. This person is the third most recent. So what I do is when I decide to follow somebody back, let me just show you what I would do here. I don't know who this Kent guy is. So I click on his name. I can look at his Twitter account. I can see that he's not a spam site or a porn site or something like that. I can see he's a real-life human being. And me being a businessman, I understand that I can never be connected to too many people. So what I'm going to do, just pay no attention to what I'm doing right now. I'm just copying something. Here's the newest person. And that's not the newest. This I'm going to go to this one right here, Jenna. Jenna looks like a real-life human being. I'm not quite sure who she is, but for whatever reason, she's decided to follow me. I open up her profile, and I can see she's in Denver in New York. She's a social media person. She's the real deal. So I have no reason not to follow her back. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to click follow back. Now I'm following her just like she's following me. And then when I click the gear, I go to send a direct message. I paste in my standard message, I change the name to Jenna, and I send her a direct message, because you can send direct messages on Twitter also, not just broadcast messages. And again, if you've seen any of my other videos, you know that everything I do really focuses on and is grounded in some very simple fundamental principles. And one of those principles is success is created one conversation at a time. Most people are way too much into the say it and spray it, throw a lot of mud on the wall kind of thinking. I don't think that way at all. I think very, very laser focused, and I focus on one person at a time. So what I'm doing here is I'm extending my hand in friendship to Jenna and seeing if she will respond back. She either will or she won't. I'm not going to lose any sleep either way. But there's another feature here that says add or remove from list. So if I wanted to put her into one of my lists, if I wanted to put her into my social selling list, now she's tagged in my social selling list. Okay, so when I go on Twitter, I rarely, rarely open up Twitter and just look at the homepage on Twitter, because it's too much like drinking from a fire hydrant. What I do is I open up Twitter, I go over to my lists, and I ask myself, what am I interested in being updated on? If I go to my social selling list, you can see here, I click on that. I have 171 people that I've tagged in this list, and it's private, so nobody else can see who's in my list. You can make it public or private. I prefer private. But now I'm only seeing the messages known as tweets, and we can cover that more in another session on what to tweet and how frequently to tweet and all that kind of stuff. But now I can actually see just the tweets from these 171 people. 6 minutes ago, this person tweeted this. 8 seconds ago, this person tweeted this. 25 minutes ago, this is a much, much more effective use of your time. Instead of opening up Twitter and seeing this drinking from a fire hydrant experience of trying to find the needle in the haystack, just go over to your lists. You can create an unlimited number of lists, and now, when appropriate, when you're following somebody back, if it makes sense to tag them, and I'm going to untag her right now because I don't want her to be in that list. But if I went to this person here, HFG Marketplace, they're offering health insurance or whatever, and I could follow them back, and if I wanted to tag them, I could. So that's my simple daily standard operating procedure of accepting following people back, and then where appropriate, tagging them. Just as a fast 60-second recap, when you go on Twitter, you create a Twitter account at twitter.com. You put your name in, your real name. You put a handle in, which I would suggest would be your at name. You have your picture, which is usually a headshot or something. Then you've got a larger background picture. You put in a 120-character bio, the city you live in, a link to your website or your LinkedIn profile, and you have now created your your Twitter account. You click on Discover. You go to Find Friends. You merge your email accounts, you go to who to follow. If you want to type somebody's name in here, you can. If you want to see who Twitter is suggesting, if you want to follow some fun things like sports or business or news or technology or fashion or whatever, you can do that too. And then when you do accept people and you follow them back, I would suggest you put them into lists. And that way, when you open up Twitter, you can have a much more enjoyable experience, and it won't be like trying to drink from a fire hydrant. If you go to kevinknevel.com, that is my website, and you can sign up for my free newsletter. You can get updates on all kinds of things that will help you with social selling and relationship marketing. I'm all about extending my hand in friendship and paying it forward, and I would love for you to ask me to prove it. So if I can ever help you in some way, please feel free to reach out to me. Please feel free to connect with me on LinkedIn, Facebook, Twitter. There's a 24/7, 365 cocktail party going on my Facebook wall right now. If I can ever help you, I would love to help you, and I would love for you to ask me to prove it. I'm all about paying it forward. I hope you have fun on Twitter. It's a phenomenal platform. It's great for all kinds of purposes. And on behalf of the Schweike Media Business Booster webinar series, I want to say thank you for taking a few minutes out of your busy day, and I will see you on another Schweike Media webinar down the road. God bless. Have a great day.